So, I've been wondering if I could build a VR experience just by using generative AI. Well, it would mean that all the materials, 3D models, skybox, scripts, images, animations, and sound has to be generated by AI. Well, as it turns out, I can. So, I opened up Unity and started to create my own room. I could have added just any room that I found online, but I wanted to try something. I wanted to create my own room and add AI-generated materials to it. So I went to Withpoly to generate these materials, and as I wanted to have a homely feeling, I prompted it to generate a rough textured material for the wall, a wooden material for the floor, and rubber material for the door and roof. Then I went back to Unity, added these materials to the wall, and adjusted its property to match the different sizes of the cubes. Adding the floor and roof materials were pretty straightforward. Next, I wanted some furniture for my room, so I went to Sloyd AI, searched for sofa, customized it, and downloaded it. I also wanted a statue base to showcase my 3D models, so I downloaded that as well. Then, I imported these models into Unity and arranged them in my room. Now, this was my favorite part, creating a 3D model from a video. I used LumaLab's mobile application to capture the video of my Quest 2 headset, which it then converted into a realistic-looking 3D model. In this video, you might not get a feel for it, but trust me, it's just amazing to look at. Next, I wanted to see if I could generate a 3D model from text as well. LumaLab had this feature, but sadly, it was on waitlist. Anyway, I searched for statues and chose the one that had already been generated using the same AI feature. Finally, I wanted to see if I could generate a 3D model from image as well. And luckily, I was able to find a website called ZeroDepth. Then, I imported these 3D models into Unity and placed them over the bases. Now the 3D model that was generated from the image did not have a material, so I manually added one from whatever was available in the project. Next, I created an avatar from an image using Ready Player Me, and for the animation, I used Kinetics AI to generate the animation from a video. So back in Unity, I added the avatar, created the animation controller for it, and added the animation. But I wanted the animation to play only when I press a button. So I added the button that came along with the project, and I asked the famous ChatGPT to write the code for me. It did not work in one go, but after several corrections, it worked. Now to decorate my walls, I wanted some images, and I'm pretty sure you guessed it wrong. I did not use Midjourney. Instead, I tried three different websites, Prepix, Night Cafe, and Canva. But for all the three, the prompt remained the same, and I was happy with the results. So back in Unity, I hung those images right above my sofa. At this point, I thought it would make sense to let the users know how exactly each of those objects were generated. So I labeled the ones that I could. Next, I needed a skybox, so I went to Blockit Labs and generated one. I was not happy with that, so I generated it once again by prompting it to exclude the vehicles. This time, it looked much better, and so I added that to my scene. Finally, I needed a background music, so I went to SoundDraw and picked a few templates and created my own background music. I thought it would be funny to have an actual AI-generated song with an AI-generated lyrics, and that's exactly what I did here. So for the last steps in Unity, I added the background music and the AI-generated song. And with that, I had my demo exhibit for VR ready.
A quick disclaimer, all of this did not work in one go. There are so many AI tools out there and I had to try almost all of them. And I chose the ones that were free to use and produced a decent quality product. However, if you have a budget and quality is something that matters to you, then you can try out the paid website as well. Also, this project was put together in a couple of hours. So just imagine what you could do if you spend more time on it. Anyway, if you end up doing something cool after watching this video, then make sure to share it with us either on LinkedIn or Discord. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next one.